गुड आफ्टरनून स्टूडेंट्स. सो टुडे वी विल सी चैप्टर 10 विजुअलाइजिंग सॉलिड शेप्स. द कॉन्सेप्ट ऑफ दिस चैप्टर यू ऑलरेडी लर्न इन लोअर स्टैंडर्ड, दैट इज इन 7th स्टैंडर्ड, एंड दैट वी हैव सीन सम सॉलिड शेप्स एंड हाउ दे कैन विजुअलाइज ऑन अ डिफरेंट डायरेक्शन, विद द डिफरेंट डायरेक्शन, दैट इज ऑन द टॉप व्यू, फ्रंट व्यू, साइड व्यू, दैट वी विल सी इन दिस चैप्टर. सो यू आर गिवन सम शेप्स, दैट इज दिस इज योर square, cone shape, cylindrical shape and triangle. So type of shapes means whether it's a two dimensional shape or whether it's a three dimensional shape. In two dimensional shape we have only length and breadth, but in three dimensional shape we have the third coordinates, that is your height. So this is the cone, that is in three dimensional shape. This is cylindrical, that is also in three dimensional shape, and this is your triangle, that is of two dimensional shape. So here you are given type of shapes, in that you have to match it, and this is the name of shape that you already learn in lower standard. Next we have, this is your cube. This is three dimensional shape of cube. Square is a two dimensional shape, in that we have only length and breadth, but square, this cube has third dimension, that is your height, length, breadth, and this is your height. Next is your circle. Circle has only one dimension, that is this boundary, but this is sphere, this is your three dimensional shape, and this is cuboid, this is also a three dimensional shape. Rectangle is your two dimensional shape because it has only length and breadth. But cuboid, you have third dimension, that is your height, length, breadth and height. So a tent, if you observe a tent, it is a shape of cone. A tent, a cone surrounded on a cylindrical shape. So this is the shape of cone and this is the shape of cylinder. Next you have a tin. This is a cylindrical shape. If you consider this, compare it with cylindrical shape, you can compare it like this. This is your ice cream cone. So a cone surrounded by a hemisphere. So this is your cone shape and this is ice cream, that is of hemisphere. A photo frame, this is your rectangular shape. This is a bowl. Bowl is a hemisphere shape. This is your tomb. Tomb is a cylinder surrounded by a hemisphere. So if you consider this portion, this is your cylinder and the top, this is your hemisphere. So this way we can just overview the shapes of different kinds. Welcome back students. Now some more shapes are given to you and some objects are given to you and we have to just match the column. So first one picture is an agricultural field. So you have to find it out. Where it is, what is the shape of this agriculture field. So where you can see that this is a triangular field adjoining a square field. If you observe it carefully and if you draw the middle line, so this is your square field and this is your triangular field. So combining both you will get the shapes. So what we can say for first one, a triangular field adjoining a square field. So you can join this two pictures and shapes. Next is a groove. So if you see the object, this is your cylindrical portion and from the cylindrical portion one cone is coming out. So what we can say, a cone taken out of a cylinder. So you can join this two pictures and shape. A toy, this is your toy. So what we can say, for this, a hemisphere surmounted on a cone. So this is your hemisphere, that is surmounted on a cone. This is your conical shape and this is your hemisphere shape. A circular park. So this is your circular park. So what we can join? A circular path around a circular ground. So this is your circular ground and around that you have a circular path. A cross path. So for this is your rectangular path. So what we can say for this shape, two rectangular cross paths inside a rectangular path. So this way you can join the pictures and shapes. Now next is views of 3D shapes. So this much we have already done. Now views of 3D shapes, that is also you have done front view, side view and top view. So this is a picture of herd. How it looks if you see it from top, from side and from front. So this is the front view, you can see only this much portion. And side view you can see only this much portion, and top view you can see only the top portion. So the pictures how it looks is already given. Next you have given a glass. So this is the side view. If you view it from top, it is a circular path. If you view it from the bottom, it is also a circular path. But what is the difference? The top view, the circle is bigger compared to the bottom view. So why is the top view of the glass a pair of concentric circles? Will the side view appear different if taken from some other direction? If you take a glass and if you observe from any direction, side direction, it looks like same for every time because there is no change in the shape. And for this, this is your bottom part. The small circle is your bottom part and the bigger circle is your top part. So this, that's why you can see two circles. One is inside, that is smaller circle, that is of just because of this bottom part, and one is the upper portion, that is your upper part. So this, just because of this reason, we can see two pair of concentric circles. Turn the page. Next you have given a brick, and for brick you have to make front view, so it is a rectangle, side view it is a big rectangle, and top view, two rectangles are there. So this way you can observe each and every objects according to you. You can also draw the diagrams how it visualizes when you observe that particular thing from the top, side and bottom. So many objects are available at your home. You can consider a table, dinner, you can consider the dining table, you can consider the your textbook also, you can consider the chair also, sofa set also, and you observe it from the front view, side view and top view. And if you want, you can draw it and just identify which kind of diagram you will get. Okay, next we will see some specific diagram. So here is your 1, 2, 3 cubes are there, 1, 2, 3, and it arranged such like this, and we want to find what is the top view. When you observe it from the side view, you can see this portion, only rectangular portion. If you see from the front, front means this side, so you are observing 1, 2 and 3 squares. And if you see it from the top view, so if you observe from the top view, this is your first square and this is your second square. You can see both the square together, so that's why the diagram is like this. Suppose you have this kind of diagram. So this is your top view. How many squares are there? 1, 2, 3, 4. These two squares are adjoining squares. So this is 1, 2 adjoining. Okay. Then side view. Side is 1, 2 and 3. So this is your side view. 1, 2 and 3. And front view. You are observing this and this. So front view you have only two squares. Next is this diagram. This is a top view, front view and side view. So front view you have only three square, 1, 2, 3. Side view you have two square, this one square and this second one, so two square. And top view you have 1, 2, 3 and this one, four square. So this way you can just observe the side, front and top view. Thank you.